You are watching the Poor Boys Horology Podcast, the podcast for watch enthusiasts on a budget. Your host for today's podcast is Dr. Ed DeVries, an amateur horologist whose personal collection includes Timex, Rolex, and everything in between. If you are interested in dive watches, dress watches, designer watches, military watches, automatic watches, hand-winding watches, quartz watches, or pocket watches, the Poor Boys Horology Podcast is about to become your favorite podcast. So click like and subscribe. Then sit back, relax, and enjoy today's episode of the Poor Boys Horology Podcast.
So which came first, the chicken or the egg? Anyways, before we get to that, let me do a quick wristwatch check. I'm wearing a Casio Duro. It was a birthday gift that I received recently from our good friend Jay Cook. Remember, we had reviewed Jay Cook's watch collection in last month's Poor Boys Horology Podcast. Just got a surprise one day in the mail. And Jay had gone on to Amazon, had ordered this watch for me, and had it sent to me. So it's been a blessing, and I've been enjoying wearing it for the last 3 weeks. The chicken or the egg, which came first? I'm working on a book right now, and the book is going to be the top 10 or maybe 12 ways to make the most of your holiday shopping this year. The pandemic has just changed everything regarding the way that we do things, the way we shop, the way we do a lot of things. And so with all of the rules of Christmas shopping changing, for example, normally I would have had all my Christmas shopping done by August. I haven't hardly even started on it this year. And I'm just now getting into this. And again, how do you save time? How do you save money? How do you make the most of all of the changes, all of the new normals, if you will, with your Christmas shopping this year? And so that's going to be the subject of an ebook that I'll be writing, a Kindle book for Amazon.com. And it's like, I want to do that video. I want to do that Kindle book so that I could promote this video. Or do I do this video so I can promote that Kindle book? Again, which should come first? Which should be the chicken? Which should be the egg? Anyways, apparently it would seem now that I'm doing this video before I'm publishing the Kindle book. And so what's going to happen is the Kindle book will have within it a link to this video, so the people who read the Kindle book can come back to this video and watch it. And in the item description of this video, it's not there yet because the Kindle book has not yet been published. But once the Kindle book is published, I will have in the description of this video. So it'll be added at a later date. So if it's not there now, just come back, look for it. It'll be there eventually. The link to the Kindle ebook so that you can read the Kindle ebook. Anyways, what does that have to do with today's Poor Boys Horology Podcast? Today's Poor Boys Horology Podcast is a top 10 list of the top 10 watches that you should consider purchasing for your loved one as a Christmas gift. And I promise all 10 of these watches will come in under $100. Most of them will come in under $50. One of them, if one of you is lucky enough to snag it, is going to be amazing. A vintage watch that's brand new. It's highly collectible. It's probably worth a couple hundred, maybe even $1,000. And you can snag it for way under $50 if it's not already gone. But again, just the top 10 watches for this Christmas season, and of course, they're all under $100, most of them under $50. But first, let's have a brief word from our sponsor, The Barnes Review. 45 seconds, and we'll be back.
In your web browser and type in www.barnesreview.org and discover The Barnes Review magazine. In The Barnes Review, you will read vignettes of man, from the prehistoric to the very recent, from forgotten races and civilizations to first-person accounts of World War II and the late Cold War. There is no more interesting magazine published today, nor a more significant and important subject than real history. So visit www.barnesreview.org and subscribe to The Barnes Review. You can subscribe to receive the Barnes Review magazine in its print form, or in convenient electronic delivery. Our host has been a subscriber to both formats for years. So visit www.barnesreview.org and subscribe to the Barnes Review.
So what else did I get for my birthday? You see this this boom here, got my microphone, got my little screen here, and got this set back up here, and got this for my birthday. Absolutely, absolutely love it. Got this orange NATO strap from Jay Cook. He sent this along with the red strap that you see here, and along with the Casio Duro. And what I really like about this red strap on the Duro, of course, this orange strap we had showed in his watch collection, it had an orange strap, and I had commented, I thought that looks kind of cool, and so he sent me one. But he later had gotten the red strap, and he said that the red strap really brings out the red second hand on the watch. It really makes it pop, and it really does. You can't really see it because of the graininess. The lighting here in my office really isn't what it should be. I need to figure out how to make the lighting in this room better than it is. But until then, just know that we're doing our best here. What else did I get for my birthday? I got a nice little book here, The Tales of Uncle Remus, and I look forward to reading those. And I got a couple of watches for my birthday as well. Got a classic Casio watch. I don't know if you can see this or not, but it's actually a blue watch. It's not black, it's blue. Remember the old Casio? It was back when we were in high school. Well, I got the old Casio digital watch. I was mentioning to my wife how I wish I would have kept mine. From all those years ago when I was in middle school, I wish I would have kept my Casios. And so she was wandering through Walmart one day, and she saw these. They had a stack of them, and they were normally $15.88. They had marked them down to $4 a piece. And so she got a couple of them, and gave me one for my birthday there, and love it. And then this was just something that I had marked in Amazon there. I had tagged it because I wanted to come back and look at it later. And my wife thought that it was because I wanted it, and so she went ahead and got it for me on Amazon. And it's a SKMEI, SKMEI. It's a SKMEI. It's a Chinese made watch, and this is supposed to be their homage or their knockoff of the Casio World Time. Some call it the Casio Royale, and I don't know why they do, because Daniel Craig did not wear this watch in Casino Royale. In fact, this watch never appeared in any Bond film. There was a watch that was similar to it. It was a Seiko watch that was worn by Roger Moore in the 1983 movie Octopussy. And this watch is Casio's, well, this is a knockoff of the Casio, or a homage to the Casio. But Casio had designed a similar looking watch to the Seiko, and they called it the Casio World Time, and then later it became the Casio Royale. But this is SKMEI. They're in Guangdong, China, Guangdong Province. Casio has a big factory in Guangdong Province where they make the World Time watches. And so I have no doubt that probably one of the reasons why this watch looks almost identical to the World Time Casio is because I have a feeling that a lot of the same parts are being used in both watches. And but this is a SKMEI branded watch, and it was just a few dollars there on Amazon. It's actually going to make our top 10 list. And so we'll look at that a little bit later. But let's go ahead and look at our top 10 list, and let's just go ahead and get into it. And let's start with the watch that I am going to put at number 10. It's one, just so I can show it to you in the video first, we'll go from 10 to 1, and I'm going to put it there just so that I can show it to you. It's one of those watches I wish that I would have kept, and it was my Swatch. When we were looking at Jay Cook's watch collection, he still had his Swatch from middle school. I wish I would have kept my Swatch. My Swatch had the Swiss coat of arms on it. Very classy looking watch. I wish I would have kept it. And what I did is it came with like a yellow and a red strap. And eventually I replaced it. So I had just a solid black strap on both sides with a black face with the Swiss coat of arms. It actually, the watch could almost pass for a dress watch. It was a sharp looking watch. But anyways, I really wish I would have kept that Swatch. For those of you who wish that you would have kept your Swatch, look at this one here, and saw this on eBay the other day, and look at the price. It's amazing what they're going to let this go for. That's a buy it now price. That's not a starting bid. That's a buy it now price. And somebody's going to pick this thing up. Look for it on eBay. Maybe it's still there and you can find it and you're going to get a deal. This is a commemorative watch for the U.S. Olympics, which is why this watch should be a very collectible piece. And it's why this watch is going to be worth a lot of money if it's not already. And so if this hasn't already been scooped up, it now at number 9 is the SKMI World Time. It says dual time on it because it doesn't have the world time features that the Seiko has. But as far as the appearance of this watch, it looks shape, size, it looks identical. The face of these watches, at least the black plastic frame around the display, the LED display of the face, is identical. Again, I believe that they take the Casio parts out of the factory and just stamp them SKMI and put them in the SKMI watches. I think a lot of the parts are the same. I think the bands are the same. I think that the buttons, the pushers, everything, I think they're the same. I think the cases are the same. They just stamp them dual time instead of world time and L luminous on the bottom. I don't know why they put that Spanish there. Go figure. Maybe because they figured, the Chinese figured it were going to be sold in Mexican flea markets. I don't know. Speaking of flea markets, I went to the flea market the other day. In fact, this past weekend. And pretty much every booth in the flea market, and it's the first time that I've been to the flea market here since we've moved, and every booth in the flea market was either an Asian vendor or a Hispanic vendor, and so maybe they figured that, that you know, these would be sold in flea markets and that Spanish-speaking people would buy them. I don't know. Anyways, maybe I'm becoming a little bit of a watch snob over the years. However many years ago, I decided that I was only going to wear watches if they had a metal bracelet that had solid end links in the bracelet. I wasn't going to do the folded end links anymore. I just decided, you know what? I'm not going to do it. And so I got this watch, and it's got folded end links. And yet, for some reason, I found myself liking the watch immediately. I had marked it in Amazon, as I said earlier, because it was something that I wanted to go back and look at again. My wife thought that I marked it because I wanted one and the price was affordable enough. And she was, you know, buying me a lot of, you know, she normally buys me one big expensive gift every year for my birthday. And this year she got me a pressure washer. And then there were a series of smaller gifts and this was just one of them. But yet for some reason I put it on my wrist and I just decided I liked it. It was comfortable. And so I actually sized it to myself. I needed a little more than a micro adjustment. Didn't quite do it. So I needed to take a link out, and taking a folded link out is a process. It's not like a solid end link watch where you've got pins or screws that come in and out easily. There is a multi-step process to removing a link in these folded end links. And maybe that deserves its own video. I don't know. I'm not going to talk you through it right now. But I will say I put forth the work and the effort, and I sized this for myself. And I'm really glad that I did. And I actually wore the watch for a couple of days. For about 3 days, I took off the watch that Jay Cook had sent me, the Casio Duro, and I put on the SKMI World Time or Dual Time watch. And you can see on the video here, this is a Amazon, I believe, an Amazon screen that I've got come up here on the screen now. And you can see the color of the numbers and everything. And that bluish color is what you get when you push the light button. Normally, you're looking at black text, but when you push the light button, you get this bluish. It changes it from black to blue. And let me just say that you can see it in the middle of the night. You wake up in the middle of the night. You want to know what time it is. You push that little button, and even your eyes are all blurry and everything because you're all sleepy. But you can just see it, and it's clear, and I really like this blue. I really like the way this thing lights up. I also like the fact that on the Casio World Time, you've got that globe there that has a little lines across it that you can't barely see. The fact that you got the big day of the week in that place, just a whole lot better. Now, where the stopwatch feature should be, the circle there, that just kind of blinks on the SKMI. It looks cool. It doesn't really do anything, whereas that's actually a function on the Casio watch. But all in all, you know, for something that you're going to buy for just a few bucks, I got to admit, I love this little SKMI. And so it's going to make the top 10 list. And if you would just want to get the Casio World Time, you can pick that up for about $48 on Amazon. And just type in Casio World Time and it'll come up and you can get that. But this SKMI is going to be our number 9 watch. And for just, you know, somebody who just wants a basic digital watch that looks cool, you know, the price is right, and they are well-built watches. I believe that these watches are built every bit as good as their Casio counterparts. Unlike a lot of homage watches, knockoff watches, whatever you want to call them, they aren't always as well built, but these Skamis are built just as well as their Casio counterparts. In fact, if you want to go over to Jody's channel, Just One More Watch, he gives these Skamis a great review, and so I'm not the only person who's fallen in love with the Skami. Number 8, we have the Casio 3224. Just a basic digital watch. Like I said earlier in today's show, my wife picked these things up at Walmart for $4 a piece. The regular price at Walmart would be $15.88. It's a good price. It's a good buy at either price. Here on Amazon, we see it a little bit less than Walmart's $15.88 price, but a little bit more than Walmart's $4 price. Now, I will say if you get on eBay, you can find these things for, you know, $8 on eBay, $10 on eBay. You know, why did I go to Amazon here? Well, because the Amazons are genuine Casios. You would ask yourself the question, do people really knock off $15 watches? Yes, they do. And there are a lot of fake Casios floating around out there on eBay. And now on Amazon, Amazon authenticates watches. It's very hard to become a watch seller on eBay. Pretty much anybody can list a watch on eBay, but it's almost impossible to become a watch seller on Amazon. And the things that you have to do to become a watch seller on Amazon, all the documentation you have to provide, and you have to provide all this documentation showing that you're a licensed, authorized dealer. And so that way Amazon knows that you're not selling fake and knockoff watches on their platform. So you know that the Amazon watches are going to be genuine. You know the one you walk into Walmart and buy is going to be genuine. But eBay, maybe it's genuine, maybe it's not. There are some fake Casios floating around out there. Anyways, I love this watch. Just the basic digital watch. Remember the digital watches we wore when we were kids back in the 80s? This is it. And like I said, I wish I never would have let mine go. You know, this is coming in here at number 8. Pick it up. Pick up a few. Give them to the men and the boys in your life this Christmas. In at number 7, here we got the little box here. Came in from China. Actually, it was shipped from China to Los Angeles. That somebody in Los Angeles boxed it up, and they sent it to me by the United States Postal Service. But let's go ahead and do a little unboxing here. And it is the Pagani Designs. I'll call it a mocktail time. And it is Pagani Design here. It's a very nice watch. And I got a Pagani Design last year for Christmas, which was a homage to the Aqua Racer. This is their homage to the Seiko Cocktail Time watch. And the one that I picked here comes on a stainless steel bracelet with solid end links, whereas a lot of them come on leather bands. You see, we're going to put up a sheet here for AliExpress. And AliExpress is... AliExpress is going to sell this watch here for $56. I have seen them for $47, $48, $49 on eBay. So I talk about sometimes fake watches on eBay. As far as I know, nobody is out there making fake Pagani Design watches. So you're probably pretty safe getting it on eBay. If you like the Seiko Cocktail Time watch, you'll love, which is a $300, $400 watch, you will love this homage watch, which will come in at around $50, maybe even a little bit less. Here on AliExpress, as you're seeing here, $56. But if you use coupons, you'll get it for just under $50. And that'll include postage, and you'll really enjoy this piece. I haven't taken mine out of the box yet because my wife doesn't know it yet, but she's going to give it to me for Christmas. Anyways, a couple of things that I want to point out before we go to the next watch in our list is that this Pagani Designs Mocktail Time homage watch is a fully automatic watch. It's not a quartz watch. They do have a quartz model of it. So if you want that one, it's about $35, but this is the automatic version, fully automatic watch, self-winding, does not require a battery. And also, just look at that dial. Look at the way it pops. If you think it pops in the picture here, it pops in the sunlight even more in real life. And coming in at number 6, the Casio G-Shock, the 5600 model. Look at the feedback that this seller has. Tens of thousands of positive feedbacks. This is a trusted seller. This is somebody who's selling genuine articles. This is not somebody who is selling knockoffs and shipping them from China to you. And so you can trust this seller. You can trust this listing. And so you'll want to check this out here. You want to look at the screen and see what you need to see here to be able to get a hold of this watch. $48 for a Casio G-Shock. Maybe you were thinking about buying a G-Shock for the man in your life, and you're saying, but you know, these are $300, $400 watches. Here's one. It's got all the features. It's $48. This is a classic G-Shock. You say, well, why is it so inexpensive? Because it's one of the older models, but yet it's got all the durability. In fact, this is one of the models that is used by the U.S. military. And, you know, the Navy SEALs wear this. The Army Rangers wear this. This is a great watch, and you can drive a tank over it. And, you know, you could fall off a mountain with this thing, and you'll be crushed to smithereens, but your watch will still be working. And so $48 Casio G-Shock. If you were thinking about buying a G-Shock for Christmas, this is the one. Again, coming in under $50, and it is number 6. And coming in at number 5 is the watch that I have on my wrist, the Casio Duro. And, you know, I had mentioned in last month's video that the watch that I wanted was a Casio that is one of their newer solar-powered watches. And it's kind of the watch that's, in many ways, maybe Casio was marketing it as what's going to be the newer Duro. It's the replacement to this Duro line of watches. But you know what? Jay Cook, he sent me this watch for my birthday. I've been wearing it for the last 3 weeks, and I've just absolutely fallen in love with it. Here, just a few days ago, he sent me this red strap that you see here. He also sent me the orange strap. They came after the watch. He shipped me the straps himself, whereas the Casio Duro, the watch, was delivered by Amazon, by the mailman. This is the original strap that came with it. It's a black plastic band here. And let me just say, this plastic strap was amazingly comfortable. I wouldn't think that it would be. I'm normally not a big fan of plastic straps. I would prefer the stainless steel bracelets or the leather straps. But the canvas NATO has a good feel to it as well. Not genuinely a big fan of the plastic, but even with the original factory plastic strap, it wore very comfortably on my wrist. And I had it out on that plastic strap for 2 weeks, and it wore very comfortably. This is just a great watch. It's got a great look. It's got a great feel. It's got a 120-click unidirectional bezel. It's very tight. It has 200 meters of water resistance, so you can actually dive in it. What Jay Cook told me, very interesting, he said that he owns a Rolex Sea Dweller, and he owns this. And what he does is, you know, he wears a Sea Dweller a lot because he likes it. But he says, when I go diving, he goes, I put on the Casio. I said, you know, why? And he told me, he said, it's really simple. He said, because if something goes smash, he goes, I'm losing a $50 watch and not a $18,000 watch. And it makes sense. And he just loves his Casio. He says, it works, it works, it works. And they're just great watches at an affordable price. You can see here on Amazon, we've got 3 different varieties, and it shows you the prices there. But the one that I'm wearing on my wrist, the plain old black version, it comes in at under $50. You know what? Bill Gates has been seen more often than not. If you look at Bill Gates, the watch that is on his wrist is a Casio Duro, one of the richest men in the world. If the Casio Duro is good enough for Bill Gates, folks, it is good enough for you. Jamie over at Just One More Watch, he recently did a review of the Casio Duro, and he gave it flying colors. He gave it one of the best reviews that he's ever given for a watch. Now, my only downside to the Duro, which is why I wanted another Casio model that looks similar to the Duro, being solar powered, is that the Duro is a battery powered watch. And I told Jay Cook that. I said, you know, I said that was my only hesitance to buying the Duro however many years ago. I said, I've almost pulled the trigger on this purchase. I don't know how many times. I said, but I just don't really normally go out and buy battery-powered watches. Now, the Casios that I showed earlier, the battery-powered Casios earlier in today's show, all have 10-year battery lives. So you're not really going to have to worry about it. The Casio Duro, on the other hand, only has a 3-year battery life. And Jay Cook told me, he said, you know what? He said, Ed, 3 years from now when your battery goes dead, he said, just call me and I'll buy you a new one. So, Jeff, I'm probably going to take you up on that 3 years from now. But let me say, I'm loving the Duro, and you're going to love it too. And so if you want a man, if you have a man in your life, you want to make him very happy, or even a woman for that matter, buy them a Casio Duro. You can shower in it. You can swim in it. You can live in it, folks. And it's under $50. You know, it looks, especially on the NATO strap, it looks like you're wearing a Rolex Submariner, although it does come in a little bit bigger, whereas the Submariner is a 40-millimeter watch. This is 44, so it wears just a little bigger on the wrist. But again, under $50, Casio Duro. You're not going to go wrong with this. It comes in at number 5 on our top 10 Christmas shopping watch list. And for our highly observant viewers who were saying, hey, is this the same guy who was in the last video just a few seconds ago? COVID-19, what's happened? Is all the barber shops closed however many months ago? And my family and I just happened to go to a barber who decided that rather than go out of business, like so many other barbers did, that they were just going to go to the house. And so for the last several months, I've kind of felt kind of special, if you will, that the barber comes to the house, and $60, actually it's $50, but I give him a $10 tip, and get my hair cut. My son gets his hair cut, cuts my wife's hair, and we're all looking really good. I get a beard to trim out of it. It just looks really good. Anyways, so I took a little pause from our recording to get the haircut, and then, of course, Game 6 of the World Series came on, so I'm going to try to film these last few watch segments in between innings of the World Series. And so now we are at number 4, and we are at a watch that I am tempted to put at number 2 or number 1, but I'm going to put it here at number 4. I absolutely love these. I own several of them. They are Vostok Commanderskis and Vostok Amphibias, but I'm going to put Russian Vostok watches with mechanical movements in the number 4 position. You can't go wrong, whether it's with the Commanderskis or the Amphibias. You just can't go wrong. If you go with the 17-jewel hand winding movement or the 31-jewel automatic movement, they're both workhorses. My personal preference is the 31-jewel automatic. And I do believe that it's a better timekeeper, and I believe that you'll get a lot better service out of it in the long haul. But either way, we're putting images up here, and you can get them on Amazon. You can get them anywhere from $49 to just under $100. In fact, if you want to go to eBay and you want to order them from Russia and you want to wait a month or so for it to come in from Russia, you can get some of these 17-jewel hand-winding Vostok Commanderskis for as little as $35, and that would even include shipping. But what I would do is I would spend the $69 to $79, $89 at the most, and get the Vostok Amphibia with the 31-jewel automatic movement, and get the Scuba Dude. I think the Scuba Dude's a really cool watch, but you can't go wrong with any of the Amphibia dial designs. You can get them with the date complication, without the date complication. These things are rated to go at least 300 meters underwater. They'll probably go even further. The Vostok has a unique design. It does not have seals. And the watch, the pieces of the watch case literally compress upon one another. And so the deeper you dive and the more pressure you expose the watch to, the tighter and tighter the seal gets. So theoretically, you could go all the way down. No one's ever tested it. But these Vostoks are great watches. They're made in Russia. I have several of them that were made in the old Soviet Union that are older than I am, that have never seen a watchmaker, and they've never been serviced, and yet I strap them on my wrist, I wind them up, they run, they keep really good time. They are just workhorses. These things were designed for the Russian military after World War II, And the Russians took like the Rolex Submariner and some of the other military watches, and they reverse engineered them, and they came up with their own designs, which I believe are superior to the designs of the European made watches. So you can't go wrong with these Vostok Amphibias and these Vostok Kommandirskis. And now, to get the best deals on them, you do have to order them from Russia. And so do expect to have in other words, order them now so that they'll be here in time for Christmas. Expect them to take a month to 6 weeks to get here from Russia. But if you go on Amazon, or if you go to an eBay American seller, sometimes you can get them from people that will ship in the United States, and you can get them within a week. But you'll pay for that privilege. Either way, you can't go wrong with the Vostok Kommandirski and the Vostok Amphibia. So the man in your life can be wearing the exact same watch that Vladimir Putin wears, the exact same watch that Bill Murray wears. And now at number three is a watch that... the reason that I'm ranking it ahead of the Vostok is because I already own several Vostoks. I do not own a Pagani Design Daytona chronograph. And I'd love to have one. In fact, I've almost pulled the trigger on buying one a few times here in the last few months. Let me say, if you're sitting out there and wondering, what do I get Dr. Ed for Christmas? A Pagani Design Daytona style chronograph would be wonderful. These watches, just look at the watch. It's a beautiful watch. It looks just like the Rolex. Maybe because it's probably coming out of the same factory in Guangdong province that so many of the fake Rolex Daytonas come out of. I don't know. But this is not a fake Rolex. This is a Pagani Designs branded chronograph watch. It comes with a Japanese movement, the VK63 to be exact. And this is a 6-tick per second quartz movement. It's 6 ticks per second. It looks like you have a sweeping second hand. It looks to be an automatic movement. And yet it's still a quartz. And the fully functioning chronograph, it's got a beautiful ceramic bezel. You've got all kinds of options here. What I'm showing is one that I just really like the look of. It is the rose gold with the black dial and the black ceramic bezel and the black rubber strap. But they have so many different versions to choose from. You've got a full stainless steel bracelet. You've got gold-plated bracelets. You've got rose gold bracelets. You've got rubber straps. You've got leather straps. There are so many different varieties of this watch to choose from. You can get full stainless with blue bezel and blue dial. You can get full stainless with black bezel and black dial. Full stainless with stainless bezel. And just so many different varieties of this watch. It comes in at $86.99 on Amazon. You get free delivery. But they do ship these from China. So you're not going to get two-day delivery. In fact, it's October 27th today. And it's showing the delivery day to be between November 18th and December 10th. You can go to AliExpress. You can get this same watch for about the same price. You might be able to get a little bit quicker shipping from AliExpress if you pay for express shipping. The difference being, of course, is that AliExpress doesn't always guarantee their shipping times, whereas Amazon does. You might could find these watches on eBay from an American seller. Again, you just have to see what's out there. But this is a beautiful watch. It's every bit as beautiful as the Daytona. In fact, I have a friend of mine. He had one of these, and he put it right side by side to his Rolex Daytona. And I got to tell you, the Pagani was a sweeter looking watch than the Rolex. This is just an awesome watch. It would make a great gift for the man in your life, and or if you just want to treat yourself. Pagani Designs, even though it's a quartz watch, it's fully functioning chronograph. The battery, you should get about 3 years out of the battery on these things. It's just a beautiful watch. And so it comes in here at number three. And at number two is another SKMI. This one being the SKMI Transformer watch. Transformers, robots in disguise. Autobots wage their battle to destroy the evil forces of the Decepticons, the Transformers. Remember those? And back in the 80s, there was a Transformers watch, and you could take it off the band, and you had a little robot that you could unfold and you could play with. And then those watches went away, but Skmee has brought them back. And I do not believe that these are an actual licensed product, but they are so cool nonetheless. And of course, the video that you've been watching is compliments of Jody over there at the Just One More Watch channel. Let me say that if you're not a subscriber to Jody's Just One More Watch, you need to become one, because Jody just does a great job of bringing out these watches, and especially these Chinese watches. He's really been reviewing a lot of those in the last several months. But Jody just does a great job of finding watches, affordable watches, and doing first-class reviews of them. And so you definitely want to go over to Just One More Watch, type in Just One More Watch in your YouTube search engine, and when Jody's channel comes up, click subscribe. You'll be glad that you did. But this right here is the Skmee Transformers watch, and I'm putting it here at number two because I know all of you have a little boy or a little girl on your shopping list, and this would make a great stocking stuffer, especially if they're not into watches. You give them one of these, and they'll say this is cool, and it will spark their interest in horology and in collecting watches. And so that's why I'm putting it at number two, because grown men will love it, grown girls will love it, grown women will love it, little boys and little girls of all ages will love this Transformers watch made by Skmee. And as you can see here, it's available on AliExpress for just over $5. And of course, you use the coupons, and it's under $4. In fact, if you made a larger order on AliExpress and you know how to use the coupons and the codes, you could probably get this little puppy absolutely free. But it's just a beautiful watch. It's a fun watch. And they've got the battery code printed right on the back of the watch. And it's a 20-cent battery replacement. So if the battery goes dead on this, you just pop a 20-cent battery in there, and you're good to go all over again. It's just, at number two, the Skmee Transformer watch. It's just a lot of fun, and you can't go wrong with this one. And finally, coming in at number one, the Invicta Model 30423. This is a homage of a Seiko Diver, and what a beautiful watch that it is. Yes, it is an Invicta, but unlike some Invictas, this one is not overbranded. It has the Invicta logo on the dial, as it should. However, it does not have the Invicta logo secondhand, and it doesn't have the Invicta etched along the side of the case. This is just a beautiful watch. And the reason that I picked this black and orange design is because, as I showed earlier, Jeff Cook had got me this wonderful orange NATO strap, and I need a watch to put it on. And this is going to be the watch. I know that one of our viewers is going to give me this watch as a Christmas gift, and I am going to forever be grateful to you for having done so. And when you do, I'm going to take off that hideous black plastic strap that it comes with, and I'm going to put on this beautiful orange NATO strap that came from Jeff Cook. Of course, this is a 22 millimeter strap, and that has 22 millimeter lugs here on the Invicta Model 30423. It comes in at just under $100. On Amazon.com, it sells for the same price on eBay, and there are other places you can get it as well. This is just a beautiful watch, and it's got the Seiko NH35A movement within it, so it's got a powerful, reliable workhorse movement. It's got a solid stainless steel case. It's got a screw-down crown. It has a flame fusion crystal, a 200-meter water-resistant rating. This is just a high-end quality watch. This has every bit of the quality of the Seiko Diver that cost over $300, and you're getting it here for under $100. You just can't go wrong here, folks. And again, I put it at number one because this is the watch. If I could pick any watch that I want to get for Christmas this year, this is the watch, and that's why I'm putting it at number one. The Invicta Automatic Watch Model 30423. Homage to the old Seiko Diver. And if you'll stay tuned, we're going to have a brief commercial from Paradise Bahamas Cruise Lines, and it's just a short little commercial, about 30 seconds, and then we'll be back, and I will have two bonus watches for you. That's right, two bonus watches. They did not make the top 10 list, but I felt like I needed to include them, and coming up after this.
Sail on a two-night Bahamas Paradise cruise from just $149. Cruise and Bahamas resort stay options also available at amazing prices. Call 800-814-7100. That's 800-814-7100.
And as promised, two bonus watches. One is on the low end, one is on the high end. We'll start with the low end watch, and this is one that I came across when I was looking up Casio Duros. And I found these here on eBay, and it is a Chinese seller, and they are claiming to be selling replica Casio Duros. You say, well, why in the world would someone make a replica of a $48 watch? That's a good question. And they're selling these replicas for just $12. I've never seen one of these replica watches. I've never held one in my hand. I don't know anything about them except for what I am seeing right here on the screen, the same thing that you're seeing. Let me say this, that if these are indeed replica watches, they claim that they have the same specs as the Casio Duro, the 200 meters of water resistance and so forth. If that is the case, at $12, these watches are an absolute steal. Then again, they may just be absolute junk. I don't know. They look like the Casio Duro. I'm going to guess that they're probably pretty close to or maybe even the same, only because I know that Casio has a big factory in the Guangdong province of China, and I'm going to guess that the same Chinese factory that makes the real Casio Duros makes these replica Casio Duros. They probably make them from the same parts. And so this is probably just an unbranded Casio Duro, and if that's the case, $12, great watch. You know, I think I might even pick a couple of these up myself to give as gifts to some people, some kids and so forth that I would have to give a watch to this year. And if they turn out to be a great watch, then, man, this is a steal of a deal. And if not, well, then, you know, some kids had something cool to wear until they wrecked their bike or, you know, in other way, shape, or form, smash. And that's what happens a lot. I know my son, he tends to smash up a lot of watches, and a lot of kids do that. And so at $12, this is a great watch to give to those kids on your list. So, you know, if somebody needs a watch that they need to wear in a rough environment, maybe you work on a construction site, or maybe, you know, you have some type of a job where you're really hard on a watch, a $12 watch, you know, it'd be a good, you know, why smash up a $48 watch if you can smash up a $12 watch? And so this is the first bonus watch. The second bonus watch is the Orient 3 Star. And what made me think of this, it didn't make my list when I was prepping for this show, but I was at the flea market this weekend. I talked about that earlier in today's show. And there was a Chinese lady and she had a booth. And she had all kinds of watches there. And I was looking at several of them. And they were all fake. She had fake Rolexes, $120. She had fake Seiko 5s, $120. She had fake Orient 3 Stars, $120. I told her, I said, you realize that I could buy this Orient 3 Star on Amazon.com for $75. And it ships directly from the Orient factory. It's the real deal and not a fake. And the Chinese lady kind of laughed, and so I tapped on my phone and I showed it to her, and then her laughter turned to something very mean. But at any rate, why in the world would someone even want to make the effort to make a fake knockoff version of a $75 watch, let alone to sell it for $120? But I know that these fake Orient 3 Stars are floating around out there. Obviously, I'd seen some at the flea market this past weekend. A couple of years ago, I was on Wish.com, and it was actually my first experience with Wish.com, and I saw these Orient 3 Stars for $35, and I said, wow. I said, let me order one of those things, and so I did, and it came in the mail about a month later from China, and it was as fake as a $3 bill, and so, long story short, PayPal was so good, and they gave me a refund, but the Orient 3 Star is a great watch. Orient is basically Orient and Seiko are the same company, so this essentially has a Seiko movement in it, has a day-date complication. It has the classic Seiko movement in it, basically. This is a watch that will outlive you. It's not the, it's not the most fanciest looking of watches, but it's not an unattractive watch either. We're going to show two different variations here. One, I believe, came from an eBay listing on Joma Shop. And by the way, Joma Shop is a quality place. You don't go wrong there. Joma Shop sells the genuine article. They don't sell junk, and they don't sell fakes. So I know there are a lot of fakes floating around on eBay, but if you're buying from Joma Shop on eBay, you know you're getting the real deal. And this has kind of like a champagne dial here. And then we're also going to show a blue dial variation from Amazon.com. And you'll see here the Orients on Amazon ship directly from the Orient factory. They're sold by the Orient store on Amazon. And so you know, again, that you're getting the real deal. Both of these sitting right at the $75 mark for the Orient 3-star. Now, I don't own a 3-star. I own an Orient Bambino. I do not own a 3-star. But if someone were to give me a 3-star, I would not turn my nose up at it, because they are absolutely great and beautiful watches in their own right. They're a little bit of a smaller watch, but some people like to have a smaller watch on their wrist as well. And so those are our two bonus watches. As we're getting towards the close of the year here, maybe you would like to advertise here on the Poor Boy Horology Podcast. If so, send me an email, poorboyshorologypodcast@aol.com. The email address is on the bottom of your screen. Say, hey, Dr. Ed, I would love to advertise on an upcoming show. Right now, we're still offering advertising for as little as $10 per podcast. But when these things start taking off and the viewer numbers start getting higher and higher, of course, then we're going to have to raise our advertising rates. So get in now while the price is low. And then, of course, when this thing really takes off and when we start to bust the viewer numbers, you'll already be on the ground floor of this and you'll already have your advertisements in. Of course, the advertisements stay there. So 6 months from now, 6 years from now, 60 years from now, people could be watching your advertisement and you could get it for as little as $10 an episode. And so prepay as many episodes as you can. Lock that in. You see, we've got a couple of great advertisers that have been with us today. And we've had some great advertisers over the course of this past year. If you buy one of the watches that's here on our program today and you want to send me an email, tell me what you thought about it. Again, poorboyshorologypodcast@aol.com. Well, thank you for tuning in. Thank you for being a part of our family. And I hope that you have a very, very happy Thanksgiving, just in case I don't get the November podcast out before Thanksgiving. And hope that something in today's podcast gave you an idea to help you with your Christmas shopping.
Extra, extra, read all about it.
If you're like me, and I'll bet you are, you like to be on the cutting edge of honest news and accurate information. 26 times a year, the American Free Press newspaper can be delivered to your door, packed with the kind of uncensored news that I know you're going to appreciate. If you're ever dissatisfied with your subscription to the American Free Press, their guarantee is that you just drop them an email and they will gladly refund the unused portion of your subscription. So what are you waiting for? Visit www.americanfreepress.net. Once again, www.americanfreepress.net. And find out about the American Free Press. Do it today.
Extra, extra, read all about it.
Well, I'll give him another 20 minutes. But that's it.
That, of course, being the absolute ending of the 1980 motion picture Airplane, which was one of my favorites. I don't know how many hundreds and hundreds of times as a child I watched and rewatched and rewatched that movie. And just a classic, just loved it, loved Airplane 2. And I remember at the end of the credits, one time I was watching that movie, and it was like the second or third time I'd watched it. And I actually sat there for whatever reason and watched all the credits. And then at the end, of course, there was yet another scene. And so after that, I always made a point to watch all of the credits of a movie just in case they put something special there at the end. I didn't want to miss it. And so for those of you who have been faithful to watch to the very end, those of you who've learned that life lesson, I have something very, very special for you. Two more bonus items. The first is this set of Rolex Submariner-styled cufflinks. Each individual cufflink being a working quartz-powered watch. And so you don't have to slide your cuff to look at your watch. You just simply turn up, look at your cuff, and you can tell the time right off your cufflink. If that's not cool, I don't know what is. It comes in just under $100, $89 to be exact. It's up there on your screen. You'll want to look into this. And then the second one is from a little company in Australia called Clinks. And for $29, you can have cufflinks with the Rolex crown. Both of these would make great stocking stuffers, great presents for the man in your life, especially if he wears French cuffs and cufflinks. And so now, this is the end. Fade to black.